Hey friends, in this video, I'll be showing you how I automate unlimited meta video ads to test for free on n8n. By the end of this video, I'll elaborate step by step, note by note on how to create this automation. These here are the three output examples of what can be automated. This automation is born out of the frustration of waiting for video ads. So I run a lot of meta ads. A common frustration I have is I always need to wait for new video ads to come. And sometimes it might take a few days and 1 week, and there are a lot of external variables which I don't have control of. So I mostly created this automation for myself to just create a bunch of video ads and hopefully maybe beg my clients to approve for fast testing. These automated videos are not the best creatives per se. The main objective of these creatives is to gather quick insights and iterate on good performing insights. And these would then be ported to real creatives. In a world where AI avatar ads are plentiful, people may have a negative sentiment towards them. So the moment you see an AI ad, you exactly know what's happening. I don't have hard, solid proof on this, right? But it may turn some people off. The purpose of these automated videos is to skip people's judgment against AI-generated ads by making it not immediately AI recognizable. So I'm testing this automation on this product called the 52 Questions. So this is the website. It's basically a poker card deck with customized couple questions that aims to build better relationship with couples. It's meant to be a fun product. Starting with the first workflow, it is the AI Strategizer. It brainstorms messaging angles based on your brand or product. So this is the first very simple workflow that starts off this automation. It's a manual trigger and you have this send note over here. This is where you populate context for the LLM in terms of brainstorming how to potentially market your product or service. The product service name here, it's the 52 questions before getting married deck. The target audience is pre-committed or engaged couples in Singapore. The core functions are as such. I'll encourage you to populate as much detail as you can about your brand or product or service, because this gives the LLM better context in terms of how to market your product. There's this other info here. I just directly copied all the text on this website over here and copy pasted it over here. After that, I have a strategic A/B tester proposal, and this here is the prompt I'm using. You are a chief strategy officer specializing in direct to consumer marketing and growth marketing. You excel at translating brand information into actionable data driven test plans. This section over here provides context to the LLM based on the previous note we created. This is the most important part of the prompt. Your task is to generate a comprehensive A, B, C, D, E, F messaging test plan. I would love a little bit more options, and that's why I'm telling the LLM to generate A, B, C, D messaging. So think of A, B, C, D, E, F messaging as different content buckets in terms of how you can market a particular product. Crucially, you must also identify the three most critical buckets to test if resources were limited. I'm also using an output parser. Do make sure you take this to make sure that it outputs the data in a structured manner. Once you have the prompt here, I would strongly recommend you to ask it to generate an example for you. In a structured output parser, this is something you can do as well. So I've also populated some sample examples over here so that the LLM knows what kind of data to output. While it's executing, I'm using the Google Gemini chat model 2.5, and I found it to be actually quite reliable. And the reason why I love Google Gemini is that the credits are extremely generous and I like using it. When it comes to using different LLMs, I like to put a lot of pressure in terms of fine-tuning the prompt as best as you can. I generally feel the output of most LLMs are the same. Of course, in edge cases, it might be slightly different. If I feel that the prompt is really strong, I actually don't see a need to A/B test it between different LLMs. The only consideration you would have there is the cost in terms of token usage. This is the output that it creates. After spitting this out, I then populate all the insights into this Excel sheet over here. You have the bucket name, which I would consider the content bucket of your product or service. And it's recommended, I'm asking the LLM to choose three content buckets to double down on, which is future heartbreak avoidance, blissful partnership building, and smart due diligence investment. I've also asked it to output a strategic pillar in terms of how you want to market your product or service. There's a psychological angle, there's a tone, there's an example of the key message, there are headline examples, there's a body copy focus and visual directions. Think of what you see here as the base of what the video scripts are generated on, because as much as possible when it comes to A, B, C, D, E, F testing of different messaging angles, I want to try to have clear segmentation in terms of how we communicate the product. For example, the emphasis in this bucket is to avoid future heartbreaks. The emphasis here is to have a blissful partnership building. The emphasis in this content bucket is to be smart and do your due diligence when it comes to entering any relationships. We then move on to the second workflow, which is the AI script writer. So the second workflow just creates a script. It starts off with a manual trigger, and then there's a brand info note. In full transparency, I just copied this from the first workflow. I then have a Google Sheet note which extracts the data from this table over here, and it only filters for bucket names which are true. And that's why you see the output of three items over here, because I've put a filter to only give me is recommended, expert, that is true. You're an expert direct response copywriter and ad strategist specializing in short-form video ads for social media. This is the prompt that I'm using, and you can see here, this is the context that it is taking from the Excel sheet, and then there's all these prompts over here. I won't go into deep detail over here because I actually use the LLM to generate the prompt for me. Things I like to point out is the qualifying questions hook. For every script you generate, the very first line must be a question that the ideal customer will answer yes to. This is a concept that I took from Alex Hormozi's book, $100 Million Leads. This is a very good way to qualify people who are potentially interested in your product or service. I'm sure you realize by now, most of my prompt always outputs everything in structured data, so you can always potentially store it and reuse it. And that's why I always require a specific output format, and make sure you have the examples populated in the structured output parser over here. So after running this, it then outputs the ad script, the script name, the psychological angle, the full script text. Worried about hidden issues ruining your marriage? Unspoken assumption leads to heartbreak, even divorce. Our 52 questions before getting married deck uncovers these landmines early. Save untold pain and thousands in legal fees. It's just $15. Order via WhatsApp. Don't risk your future. This can probably pass off as a good ad that you can run with very minimal budgets on ads and see how it performs. You can see this line text over here. This lasts for 2.5 seconds. This text over here lasts for 2 seconds. This text over here lasts for 1 second. So if I can go back and show you the example, this essentially tells me how long to show this subtitle for. The duration that you see here will be very helpful when it comes to automating how long this text appears for. So after all the scripts are generated, I then have a split out node to then split it out based on one video script per item. And then I throw the output of the LLM back into an Excel sheet. So you can see here, there's a script name, psychological angle, full script text, script breakdown, bucket, strategy pillar. This Excel sheet here is where the result of this node goes to. Now that the AI scriptwriter has done its job, we move on to the most important workflow, which is the AI video editor. This is a workflow here. It's triggered manually. It then extracts the video script based on what was created. So you can see here, there are 5 items, and this basically extracts the video scripts from these items over here. The next thing it does is then extracts the required script, and you can see here the required text. There's a line text over here and the duration in terms of seconds, which will be very useful later for editing. I then have a loop node over here because there are 5 video scripts. The first thing I do here after this loop node is to transform this into an SRT file. So if you're not sure what an SRT file is, it's basically like a text file where a video editing program can read and know exactly where to put specific subtitles on. So this is the format in which it's needed for a video editor to recognize exactly where to place the subtitles at. So you can see here, 0 seconds to 2.5 seconds, it will then display, worried about hidden issues ruining your marriage. It takes the format of this over here and translate it into something that is ready to be used by a video editor. And the video editor I'm using is actually FFmpeg. It's like a free and open source software project where you can write code to edit videos for you. The next node here then converts the SRT file into a binary file. And this is where I'm creating a binary file. The reason why I'm creating a binary file is I want to write it on my computer. So the n8n I'm using right now is actually locally hosted, so it saves the file onto my computer. Why do I want to save the file onto my computer? It's because I then want to use this file, which is on my computer, to then be utilized by FFmpeg. Think of these SRT files that are written on my computer as raw materials that FFmpeg needs to use to edit my video later on. The next node after writing the SRT files on my computer will be to extract the SRT. Why do I want to do this? Because I actually want to extract the video themes per subtitle lines. If you haven't edited videos in your life before, right? Long story short, if the text of the video says, dream of a marriage free from painful surprises, you want to somehow choose a clip that is related to marriage free or painful surprises. What I'm asking this LLM to do right now is to extract and analyze an ad script and its corresponding SRT file to prepare it for visual asset selection. First, identify the main themes and keywords for the entire script. Secondly, go through each line of the provided SRT file and extract specific keywords for that line only. You can see here, this is a full script and there's an SRT file. If I can show you the output of it, you can see the global keywords represent what this video is about. So this, I would say, is where perhaps the magic is, the subtitle chunk. So line one, which is the first line of subtitle, do you truly know your partner's deepest values? So this, of course, the keywords are partners and values. If I can find some footage related to, let's say, couples talking to each other, that might be good. So the second line item over here is, our deck has 52 hard-hitting questions. Deck, questions. So of course, when the subtitle displays our deck has 52 hard-hitting questions, I want the footage to be chosen to be related to the product or service that is mentioned over here. The third line over here is essential pre-marriage due diligence. So due diligence, you can think of, let's say, like studying or maybe like meeting a lawyer. So if I have any footage that represents due diligence, that might be a suitable clip that I can use it over here. So on and so forth for the other subtitle chunks. After the keywords are created, this is where, in a sense, the magic happens, where you have a video database of all the videos that you have chosen. I actually am using this thing called NocoDB, which is an open source Airtable alternative. I've uploaded 3-second clips of the product into a Google Drive, and these are the variables I have. I have the web view link. If I select this and I open it, this is just a pure video that I have of the product over here. So all these are raw materials for the LLM that it can choose. You can see here there's a keywords associated with each of the clips accordingly. So there's poker card, marriage. If you're not sure about video editing, there are different shots that you can take, right? A wide shot, a medium shot, a close-up shot, a macro shot, which is an extreme close-up shot. There's an ad roll also, you have a mood, you have the duration, and you have additional remarks. I must say, I have not really done this segmentation very well. I'm actually in the midst of doing this for actual client and testing it. Let me show you how a decent database looks like. As you can see here, the format of this is exactly the same. You can see the keywords, which are very colorful, and each keyword here represents different themes. So if I go back to my video editor, right, you can see if the keyword is poker card marriage, it will then sort of try to find a video clip which has poker card marriage. This is an actual client that I've actually done a lot of labeling for. And you can see here, I've also additional remarks over here. And the truth is, this is where the manual part comes in, where I will say I've not automated this for now, because I've manually inputting and telling the LLM, okay, for this 3-second clip over here, this is actually footage of blah, 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 blah. For privacy reasons, I've actually censored it, but I hope you get the thought process when it comes to labeling the clips. So this is the database for the 52 questions. I've not taken the time to label it as precisely as possible. And that's probably the reason why the footage here isn't very good. If I take the time to really go through every single clip and write some additional remarks on what this video clip is about, I'm pretty sure the quality of it will be much better. So it then gets the database over here and then aggregates everything into a single line item, because this here returns 41 items. And the reason why there's 41 items over here is because there's 41 videos over here. From my experience, I'll recommend you providing it as many video clips as possible, just so the LLM has more resources in terms of choosing what clips are most relevant to your video script. For this edit few note over here, is actually not doing much. It's just extracting the global keywords and subtitle chunks. This is just for me to use later on. This code node here then also extracts the SRT time, which will then be used for FFmpeg later. Subsequently, I do use a lot of merge nodes, because the main objective here is to prepare everything for the clips chooser. So if you can see here, I have the video data, I have the global keywords, I have the subtitle chunks, and I have the SRT timings. This is the video data over here, and this is the data from the NocoDB database. You then have the global keywords over here, which is meant to give the LLM a big picture of what the video ad is about. And then you have the subtitle chunks and you have the SRT timings. So this LLM here is the clips chooser. I would dare say this is where also the magic happens. So this is pretty exciting for me. The prompt here is, you're an expert AI creative director for a high energy social media video ad. Your task is to create the final shortlist by selecting the best video clips from a provided library to match an ad script. So you can see the prompts over here. Relevance king, the clip chosen for a subtitle line must be highly relevant to the line keyword. This is where the context is provided to the LLM. The video data is over here. The global keywords are here. The subtitle chunks are here. And the SRT timings are over here. So you can see here, this is probably quite a big mess. And here is the output. There is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 clips that are used. It gives you the reasoning. This is where you might want to fine tune the database that you provide it, because I will say the better the quality of the database, the quality of the video clips that it creates should also be better. I will also add, there's actually room for me to automate this video watching by an LLM. If you aren't sure, I've also created previous workflows in terms of analyzing video ads, and I can actually pass all these videos to Gemini to actually label it for me. But for now, I think I'm happy to just manually write it. But I would say it's extremely painful, and it's definitely a process in which I want to automate. Imagine if all the keywords here, the short types, the ad row, and the additional remarks can be populated by an LLM. I think this is where it can really take automation to the next level. I then have a code node which extracts the file name and download links. These were the specific video clips that were chosen by my LLM for my video ad. The next thing I do is then prepare it in a format which is ready for FFmpeg to utilize. I then have a Google Drive node to get the background music I'll use in the ad, and then convert it to a format which I'll use later in terms of creating the FFmpeg code to edit the videos. The next thing here is a consolidation of links, which then aggregates all the raw data we need for FFmpeg to then edit the video. So I have the background music over here. It's basically a direct link where if I open this in a new tab, it then downloads the file immediately. You can see here, this is the background music I'm currently using. Essentially, FFmpeg will then download the file and then use it to edit the video. The next thing here is a formatted SRT file. This should be a file that is located within your computer itself. And then there's a sequence of video clips in the array format. So this was previously prepared in one of the code notes that I showed earlier on. You also have the total duration of the video, which is important to tell FFmpeg later. After you consolidate all the raw materials, right? In full transparency, I will tell you that I don't code myself. I'm just feeding the consolidated links to an LLM and asking it to generate a code for me that can be used in FFmpeg to edit a video. So I do know that all these code things looks really very intimidating for people. My understanding of JavaScript is only minimal. I still roughly understand what's happening. And if there are certain errors that I need to adjust, I can go in and adjust the code myself. How I went around it is actually just to ask LLM, I have all the raw materials, just generate a dynamic code node for me based on all these variables in a manner where I can just output a code to be sent to FFmpeg directly so that it can edit the video. It then spits out this long thing over here. And to be honest, I have no idea what it is. It's important to have this FFmpeg command and an output file name. So this is the output of the file name just for documentation purposes. After this FFmpeg code, I then have the execute command, which is by far the most important node. I will also caveat to say that you need to have FFmpeg installed in your computer. If you don't have it, go and install it. It's free for everyone to download. All right, so that's pretty much the automation that I created over here. Are these the best videos ever? Not really. But I would say this is a very quick start if the client has no budgets in terms of editing videos. In terms of how I envision this automation to be brought further and improved, I think it could use different templates accordingly. So there are different templates I can use or associate voice generation with scripts video. So I can potentially even use 11 labs or even voice generators, right, to create and voice over these ads itself. So maybe this is an example that I've actually automated it already. Maybe I can share it with you in a separate video as well. So this is the video over here.
Avoid a future divorce. That poker card deck could save you thousands. Stop assuming and start asking the real question.
In this case, I use the AI voice from the TikTok API. I will say the workflow that I've created is extremely messy. If I were to make it public, I need to clean this workflow up a lot. So let me know if you really want it. If not, I'll probably just use it by myself. Let me know if you have any questions, and I'll see you in the next one.